In this little video, we are going to trade the Accumulation Distribution Indicator. It's an oscillator that is shown below the candles. We are using the Forex Trading Framework as a main module. And if we speed up the trading process, you can see how our expert advisor is doing. An oscillator changes the direction from the upper to the lower end of the scale. And now we want to know how we can create an expert advisor that is able to produce buy and sell entries. To do that, please click on the little button here or press F4 in your Metatrader. And now you should see the Metaeditor window, and here we want to click on File, New, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file checkEntry_IAD. Click on Continue, Continue and Finish. And now you can remove everything above the OnTick function and the two command lines here. Let's change the OnTick function to String checkEntry, because this is what we are going to call from our main module to calculate the signal. In my case, the main module is the Forex Trading Framework. Basically, it's a collection of functions that can open and manage trades. And you could also use your own main module. It needs to contain the OnTick function, and you need to import the checkEntry_IAD file we are creating here. And the first thing we need to do is to create a string variable for the signal that will also be called signal. And we don't assign a value here because we are going to calculate that later on. We need a price array. That's a double array, so it can hold floating type values. And this array can hold several prices. And with array set as series, we sort the array downwards from the current candle. And now we can actually define the properties for the IAD expert advisor. We are going to use the IAD function. This function needs a few parameters. The first one is for the symbol name. The second one is for the period. And the third one is for the volume type. So let's click on this reference. And we learn that we can use the tick volume or the trade volume. We use underscore symbol to automatically detect the type of the chart. Underscore period to detect the time frame that is used on our chart. And the third parameter is volume_tick to get the tick volume. And now that we have defined the properties for the IAD expert advisor, we use copy buffer to fill our price array for three candles, starting with candle one. And we fill it with data for the first buffer, because it only has one line, that's the blue line here, according to the IAD definition that we have created above. And to calculate the value for the current candle, we simply look at candle 0 in our price array and assign the result to a new variable called IAD value. And if that value is below 0, so IAD value is smaller than 0 here, we assign the word buy to our signal. In the other case, if the IAD value is greater than 0, we have a sell signal, so now we assign the word sell to our signal. And in the last step, we use the return function to return the signal to our main module. As I said, in my case, it's the Forex Trading Framework. If you don't know what a framework is or how you can create one, you could also download a version from my website. So when I'm done, I only have to save the new checkEntry_IAD.mq5 file by clicking on the little symbol here or pressing Ctrl and S. And now I need to recompile my framework by clicking on the little button here or pressing F7. That worked without any errors, but I have a warning here. Oh, I made a mistake. This should be a double value. Let's save the file again, recompile the framework, and this time it worked without any errors and any warnings. So now I can click on the little button here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader, I click on View, Strategy Tester or press Ctrl and R. Let's pick the main module here, enable the visualization mode, and start a test. And here is our little expert advisor at work. And now you know how to code an entry signal for the IAD oscillator. And you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL5 code.